Daniela Wild-Jubbie-Claire. I'm a Ngunnawal Yarra woman from the Kimberleys, and I'm very, very proud to bring you to the studio to the Gimme Sessions from Jugun Yarra Country, Broome. As always, I want to pay my respects to my ancestors, past, present and emerging, and to all the First Nations people around the country and the world. Simulcasting on Galari TV, Galari Radio and Galari.com. So without further ado, I would love to introduce you to the Mango Mob.
Hello, how are you?
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
So, Gugs, can you please introduce us to yourself and the band?
So, my name's Colin Pigram. I'm a Yarra man, but I live in Derby. I've been there for over 40 years, and I'll quickly introduce you to the band. Over on my right over there is young Frank Benning Jr. Richard Rose, Laurie Churnside, and Lucy LeMann. And we all have been together for quite some time in various forms. Lucy's probably the youngest member of the Mango Mob.
Not in age, just in time in the band.
Yes, in time and place.
She doesn't want to say that. You just take that and go, yes, I'm the youngest.
Yeah, so we formed... as a band called Abandon years ago, in about 2006, with Richard and Junior. We call him Junior because his dad's Frank Benning as well, and Laurie and a few others. There were seven in the band at that time, and we ended up producing a CD.
What's the name of the CD?
It's called All the While. So Richard came up with that name. So, so we've been performing on and off in different various guises over the since then, and in different bands as well. Like Lucy used to be, she might want to mention all that anyway, Luce. Shoot it over to you.
Were you in did I read something about the Jam Tarts?
Yeah, that was the band in the 80s.
Tell me.
When I was young then.
Can you just mention who the band members were?
So it was myself and the sisters, Sophie and Anna Gare. And the tall one, as she used to be called, was Jodie Bell. So there was the four of us.
And is this our Jodie Bell?
Yes.
Is this our CEO, Jodie
no,
Bell?
No, different Jodie Bell.
Damn it, I thought I had a good one on her.
Yeah. I do see Jodie Bell on Broome Notice Board, and I have to double take, but yeah, different one.
I really thought I had Jodie Bell. I actually sent her someone a message going to the Jam Tarts.
Yeah. Hi, Jodie Bell.
And hi, Jodie Bell, our CEO. So tell us a little bit about how you guys came up with the name Mango Mob, and what are your inspirations? Like, who inspires your style of music?
I think we came up with the name. Mango Mob was a continuation of the Mango Duo and then the Trio. And as we grew, and some of the other members came back into the band, and then we had to become a mob again. So, and it changes fairly regularly. We do lots of duo, trio type gigs. Inspiration from music is all basically around country. So, well, or you know, scenes or incidents or lots of fishing influencing. So, which I suppose a lot of artists around the Kimberleys do. They talk about home or you know, where they've come from or their country, or so that's a lot of it. I think most of that and lifestyle influences that happen, you know, obviously you put them into song. And yeah, so, and we do a fairly big mix thing. We've got a few original songs unrecorded yet, so but because of the tie-up with Abandon, we play a lot of our songs from the All the While album quite regular. plus some of Lucy's songs, which she hasn't actually fully recorded yet as well, so.
I did read a dad joke in one of the things sent through about, what did you say about abandon?
We wanted to call ourselves fish and chips with tomato sauce or something hot here tonight. We've come up with abandon was abandon here tonight. That's what abandon was.
So. I love that. I mean, we've had other guests on that talk about the different names of their bands and they're just golden. And then, you know, they definitely come up with the one that suits them the most. And I have to say, especially in the Kimberleys, anything relating to mango trees, it evokes so much in all of us. You know, it's all sitting around with all the family, just sitting under the mango tree, playing music from sun up to sundown, and or every day. You know, every day is a mango tree day. So.
Well, we started off. The name actually came when we did a show in Derby, and because we always, I mean, if we were under a jiggle tree, we'd been called a jiggle tree mob or something.
We'd be like, you know? This plague, like this kind.
Whatever. But we were actually under a mango tree that day, and I said, I looked around, well, we're the mango duo, and that's how it started off. And, then it fired up from there.
And what's a place that you love to go, Uncle in the back there now, what's a place that you like to go that you feel most inspired, like a special spot on country, might be a secret fishing ground?
Yeah. it'd be Cuttings for me. Anywhere on Cuttings, across the creek, over the creek, near the opening, that would be Red Rocks, I'd say, yeah.
What is it about that place that makes you feel more inspired?
Well, because of the river and the bank on the other side, it's all flat, and, you know, you got, because near a station, it's all this country and it's flat, you know, and all the nice breeze, even though it's hot, you know, it's water, that's good. I'd say yes, Cuttings.
It's the way out from the Fitzroy River to the King Sound, so.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So that's where probably it is special. It's something that's been going on for generations, you know, for millennium, and it's got to continue on that way as well. So, yeah, especially because I mean, it's not just a fishing spot. It's pretty special bit of country that it gets replenished every wet season, and it feeds the whole King Sound area as well, so it's probably in the dreaming of all the local people, so.
Yeah, coming in from the Murrawarra into the ocean, coming through, yeah. Lucy, so tell us a little bit about your journey in the Kimberleys. You're saying you were over in Melbourne with a band, is that right?
Our band, yeah, a long time ago moved to Melbourne, and then some, like Jody Bell, stayed there, and also my brother Sam, because we had our brothers in the band as well, so yeah, but anyway. But then I came back to Perth, and then I've been up here nearly 5 years, and these boys have kept me busy, have to practice up on all the different instruments, so yeah, I've had to bring the saxophone out of the cupboard and the ukulele and everything, so yeah, it's been really good. So,
How many instruments do you play, and what's your weapon of choice?
With this band, I just either play piano or bass or ukulele or sometimes saxophone. My weapon of choice, actually, I like playing the bass.
Where's the bass player?
Which one?
Yeah. Everybody in this band plays all the different instruments pretty much. Everybody, if we need someone different on the bass.
Yeah, so
about three or four of us can
try and
do that
be a
role.
Little. I'm probably about the only one that's not so multi-skilled. I'll just play the guitar or the uke, but Lucy and Richard and Laurie and Junior plays the drums, but he can play guitar and he does a lot of singing. But these other three, they can play anything basically. They can jump on whatever they feel like. So.
Well, you can make that guitar jump, Uncle.
Well, it's
not just the guitar.
No, what I'm saying is multi-skilled as far as the instruments go. Yeah. Lucy's a breath of fresh air for us because she brings all this other talents that she has, musical talents.
Dancing. I'm like, you shouldn't have said that, because I'm going to get up and show us your moves right now.
No, I'm not.
How does the community, I mean, I can't imagine too many community kids in that. I remember watching something where classical music was being infused with traditional instruments. And kids, actually the person I was with had never heard a violin in live in their entire life. So I wonder what their reactions are to hearing the sax are.
Everyone loves the saxophone, but you're right, people haven't seen them so much before because it gets called anything from a violin to a trumpet or like someone will say to me, bring your violin.
Yeah, we often call it the trumpet.
Cyril calls it the trumpet. So it just gets called the trumpet pretty much.
I love that. And are you going to be playing that tonight?
No, the trumpets didn't come today.
Our range of music, we do a lot of different sort of different gigs, and playing original music is meant more for us, for what we do, for more intimate sessions, I would say. A lot of it, but some songs we don't. We play them anyway. But we do cover a lot of other songs. And I jump into a lot of the Pigram Brothers repertoire when we are out and about on tour boats and stuff like that. So makes it a bit more interesting.
Yeah, of course. And, you know, because your family also are the Pigram Brothers, and this is just for any of our people that are watching from other places in the world, but yes, Uncle's family and also has been in the Pigram Brothers, which are quite a well-known country folk band here in Australia. But in this time of COVID, fear and loathing in the time of COVID, how has that influenced your style of the sort of stories that you want to get out, or in general, your lives?
Yeah, well, for me, yeah, because sometimes I go back quite a lot and visit my family in Fremantle, and yeah, when they cut the regions, so yeah, I ended up, and where I lived at that time too was a bit of a gated community, so I really felt locked up for quite a few months. Yeah, I didn't really see anybody much.
Yeah, I think COVID for me and a lot of people in the Kimberleys, I think has been a good thing, because it's let a lot of people reconnect with each other, particularly family. You know, like, because you can't go anywhere else. So, you know, a lot of the other things, like what we do normally anyway, you know, fishing and just being with family, I don't know, I reckon it's been great. And it also opens your eyes up to the rest of the world. I see the isolation that we have, particularly without COVID, is bad enough, but when this has come along, it's been something to sort of think, oh, yeah. We couldn't even come to Broome from Derby, you know?
Mm. Yeah, so. Well, that's definitely what's happened. It's opened the people's eyes up to what the future of the world could potentially look like. I know a lot of city mob will be selling their houses and moving to the country, yeah, growing veggie patches. But we could chat for so much more longer. I want to. We'll have yarns later. So thank you so much for talking to me today. And without further ado, I'd love to welcome to the stage Mango Mob.
Thanks for the job. We travelled especially today, thanks to the NAIDOC committee for having us here, and I'd like to also acknowledge and pay my respects to the old fella that was we used to sing along with, old Bamba. So we're going to play a few of our original songs today. A few of them haven't been even recorded yet, so hopefully one day we'll get to do that. Anyway, this one's a little song that was written by someone that was in a little bit of a state when you have to go fishing all the time. One written by my son. It's called Fisherman's Bend. Dust and mud and a hard driveway. I'm going fishing, my mind's going round the bend. No one else, I'm my own friend. Highs and lows, the way tides flow, this is where I choose to go. Feeling of a lonely silence, a Neepson Springs can tell you a story about where to go, where you might find me. Dust and mud and a hard driveway, I'm going fishing, my mind's going round the bend. Burned old hand line set in the muddy creek. Out jumps the barrel, now I got something to eat. Dust and mud and a hard drive wind, I'm going fishing, my mind's going round the bend. Was the band on then, back in the day, in about 2006. That's we it. Wrote this little song. Richard actually wrote this song, and it's when everyone was trying to say sorry, but they couldn't. It's called Sorry Ain't a Four-Letter Word. Together,
the suffering in the past. We now look to the future, hoping it will last. No more sorrow, no more pain. Time to start over again. Sorry ain't a four-letter word. Another time has come. I gotta move on.
In the musical world, we all get caught in some chord. I got caught up in G's. So a lot of songs are in there. Here's a little song I wrote a few Christmases ago now. Must have been about 5 years ago. And it was looking through the eyes of my grandson sitting on a little thing they call a bumbo or something. And I was trying to picture what he was thinking. You know, this little fella sitting in this chair. And I realized that Christmas is a pretty good time. Brings everybody together, and family always catch up at Christmas time, and always seems to be the time. If you could have Christmas every day of the week, you know, it'd be good. Anyway, this one's called Full Rebound. In full rebound, endless journey, arrived on time,
People going places no one'll be will be. Taking all the glory hope some's left for me. Life in full rebound. From the sea of ingenuity, looking back at everybody, looking back at me. No need for time, just flossing around. Life in full rebound. Father Christmas, won't you come and stay? Everything seems so much better on Christmas Day. Roller coaster, sliding around. Life in full rebound. No need for time, just flossing around. Life in full rebound. Keep on smiling, little darling of mine. Life in full rebound.
Amazing how you get inspiration from things like that, but sometimes you do. what do you reckon, fellas? What are we gonna? Yeah, okay. A few years ago, we went to Cockatoo Island to do a Christmas in July, and was when the band was still a band on and not a band off, and we met this fella over there, and he kept walking around, because Cockatoo Island is a pretty cruisy sort of a place, you know. He kept walking around, and everything was good. It's good this, it's good that. So he says, we had to write this song called Skud. Come Sunday, the boys are all crook, feeling as sick as a dog, laying around all day long with the TV on, blinking an eye to take a look. I don't know, I just got here. It's good, it's all good. Scott the bloke say it's good.
The blues say it's good.
It's good.
It's good.
It's all good.
Got the blues say it's good. But the blues say it's good.
Having a few quiet ones and enough to relax. Early in the week it starts off.
The blues say it's good. Got the blues say it's good.
It's good.
It's good. It's good.
It's all good.
Got the blues say it's good.
time we're hanging out. It's Friday night. Cool time and we're cruising. Among a mopoke waiting for the sun to drop. It's all good. Scott the Blues say it's good.
Scott the Blues say it's good.
It's good.
It's good.
It's all good. Scott the Blues say it's good.
Scott the Blues say it's good.
It's all good. Scott the Blues say it's good.
Scott the Blues say it's good.
It's good.
It's good.
It's all good. Got the blues say it's good.
Got the blues say it's good.
Don't ever shoot. It's got to be good. Got the blues take a look. It's good for you. Up and you drop and it's gonna be good. Got the blues take a look. It's good for you.
Don't be a fool.
It's got to be good. Got the blues take a look. It's good for you. Drop in your mind and it's
got the blues say it's good.
Take a look and it's good for you.
Got the blues say it's good.
It's good.
It's good.
It's good. It's all good. Got the blues say it's good.
Got the blues say it's good.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Lucy's going to do a song for us now. So, song for you.
Yes, I've been away. Thank you.
Like I said before, that most songs are influenced by what you do around the place, and if you do a lot of fishing, you'll probably do a lot of fishing songs, so, which I just happen to love doing all the time, so. Anyway, this one was about a little special place that we were talking about it earlier. Cuttings is a spot where I was trying to work out how they got the Cuttings, this name. And I remember from the family that I think they used to cut a lot of sugar bag back in that area, because it's all paper bark trees, and it's right on a bit of freshwater stand there that promotes a lot of the bush bees. Anyway, that's what I want someone else to tell me otherwise, but I think that's probably why they called it the Cuttings, because all around that area is all the old where people are cut down sugar bag, and you can see the old tree scars. And anyway, apart from that, it's also the place where the Fitzroy River continuously flows in millennium out to the beautiful King Sound, feeds all the little tributaries along the way, and the giver of life to the King Sound area. So it all flows through the Cuttings and back out towards Opening Bay. They call Opening Bay as the spot that it goes out into the King Sound. And just so happens that there's some sort of agreements being come to the fruition very shortly, I think, Rich, eh? For that country, so hopefully the river will never stop wanting to flow, because when it rains, it has to. It's just where all that water goes, that's all. So anyway, a little song called Cuttings. Wind on the water says the tide's coming in. Mullets are skipping as the pelican skim to the Cuttings from Opening Bay. The cattle are moving as the windmill is calling. White cockatoo screams as the tide comes roaring to the Cuttings from Opening Bay.
We're going fishing, time to wear the line.
sing. Got that big old fat barramundi. They say that salmon's going up a devil's elbow. Man, I haven't been out there for ages. But I got no fuel. I just have to take a little walk down the jetty. Catch them big old fat catfish. Chuck him on the coals. Cook him up. Eat him up. I will do this little one. It's from a little special spot in Derby where all the countrymen go, you know? And there's probably one in every little town. In fact, I know there is, because they call them the same places. They call them Jealousy Creek. And you wonder why they'd call it Jealousy Creek, but because countrymen love to sit down and yarn. That's part of their culture, you know. You got to tell stories. And I used to always watch these people sitting around in this little dugout that goes out towards the marsh, and used to think, you know, they collect all their stories there all year, and then you wait for the rain to come, and then they all get washed out in the marsh, and they start up fresh the next year. But the good part was always listening to the, or used to hear that the local constabulary used to always come about and say, where did you get, what are you doing? What is you doing down at Jealousy Creek? So they even had the cops and everyone else that knew where Jealousy Creek was, and was in the courts. And so I thought, oh, well, what a song. Jealousy Creek, where everybody jealous about itself. Like wild water running up and down Jealousy Creek. Stories are flowing like wild water running up and down Jealousy Creek. Sitting around on a red pin-down lounge, catching up on yarns and who's doing who. Just killing time for the swinging doors, patching up another round. Stories are flowing, wild water running up and down Jealousy Creek. Stories are flowing like wild water running up and down Jealousy Creek.
You know, just now, that lot, singing along that little creek, along the holy store. Don't get them but too much shot, man. They're more sad, you know, but self now, along that little creek. Oh, Pavala, what am them call them that creek, Jalisi Creek? Them good little creek before that lot and surrounding them, Jalisi and Bats out there, eh? No more now, Yubala. Yubala gotta be good people. Yubala gotta mind them, Yubala wife. Bombay jealous of you, well, you'll be the proper one out there. Oh.
Stories are flowing like wild water running up and down and Jealousy Creek. Stories are flowing like wild water running up and down and Jealousy Creek. Up and down, 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 Jealousy Creek. Up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down, Jealousy Creek.
Oh, Pavala, Jealousy Creek.
And all the up and downs were the things that people used to do. I think we got time for one more, right? I think so. I hope so. Anyway, this little song was one I wrote before I went with the brothers to see Mr. Elton John. And, I had this little song in my head, rolling around and around and around. And they didn't want to have a bar of it, because it's not really. It's just one song that didn't quite make it into the Brothers album, so I thought a band off, a band on might do it. Mick knows this song, eh, Mickey? Come and sing it with me, bro. One called Ooh La La. Actually, I'll tell you, I had to, the real reason I wrote this song was because everybody has a la 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 song, and everyone likes la 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 songs, you know? Ooh sha la la, and ooh la la, yeah la 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 la. Anyway, this is my la la song. The money bags, leave me alone. I live on the edge in a fantasized home. The stock market share prices don't make my news. Plenty is a plenty for the little man's view. They say, ooh la la la. Entrepreneur, sitting there smiling, shaking your hand, all the while she's taking your land. They say, ooh la la la, ooh la la. Ooh la la la, ooh la la.
They say, ooh la la la. Anyway, this little we'll finish off with the song. Just another song born of a fishing trip and back of the Mira country. Getting chased out by a storm about probably this time of the year as well. And you could see all the willy-willy in the distance and coming at you in the rain clouds and bit of a storm. Anyway, this little song is called Wind Dance. I can picture your face in a storm cloud. Thunder make you grin. A lightning lights up your eye. Willy willy make you spin. He goes dancing on the water, dancing in the trees, out on the horizon, dancing for you and me. Hypnotizing the storm, take me by the hand, racing through Red Pin Dam. Catch me if you can. He goes dancing on the water, dancing in the trees, out on the horizon, dancing for you and me. Watch him dance. Following endless fence line, leading us to home. Mesmerized by sunset, we're all the dancing all alone. He goes dancing on the water, dancing in the trees, out on the horizon, dancing for you and dancing on the water, dancing in the trees, out on the horizon, dancing for you and me. Willie, Willie, dance.
Dancing, dancing.
Willie, Willie, dancing, dancing. Willie, Willie, dancing, dancing. Willie, Willie, dancing, dancing. Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Thank you so much, Mango Mob. That was too deadly. You can follow their links on galari.com. Thank you to all of our sponsors and to the Galari Gimme Sessions team. Till next time, Galia Marble.